You need to shoot your troops, man.
What are you doing?
We need to shoot your troops, Joe.
That's today?
Yeah.
Oh, come on, man. Like, I'm busy. Like, I'm fucking meditating, taking in the view. Oh, you don't interrupt somebody when they're meditating. It's like sleepwalking. I could have kicked you in the face, bro.
My bad, man.
Oh, jeez. All right, fine. Let me just get my shit together, you know? Let me put my game face on. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Rico here, CEO of Sourcefine Asia, Coastal Made in China podcast, and the host of the Sourcefine Asia YouTube channel, of course, back with another one. This is a special episode. Not only is it Halloween, not only is it one of my closest friends' birthdays, which we're throwing, I'm also doing an MTV Cribs style video of Icon Plaza. Happy Halloween. Welcome to my humble abode. All right, so this is the main living area. Let's start with this. We've got Young Wolfgang over here. Shake. So this is a furnished apartment, which is pretty common in the Philippines and also just in Asia, I think. But we wanted to add our own touches to it. So some of the stuff here was here when we moved in, and a lot of other stuff we imported from China. We had custom made stuff. So for example, this dining table was custom made here in the Philippines. So I picked out the material, I picked out the color, because the theme of the living room is white, gray, black. The theme of the apartment really is white, gray, black. So this would have been a natural wood finish, but then I had them add this like black varnish to it, so it matches everything. This rug was custom sized, and then I had my team in China ship it over here via DHL. And the funny thing is, like, the reason why I imported it is not to be lavish, it's just like, these rugs in the Philippines would have cost me like $2,000 to produce, and they come from China anyway. So I was like, okay, I went and found the material that I wanted, color that I wanted. The rug itself cost like $50, and then shipping was like $30. Well worth it. And of course we have the entertainment system here, PlayStation, VR. Got the sound bar and the subwoofer for the parties. My favorite piece in this living room is the Toronto skyline. You underestimated greatly. Most number ones ever. How long did it really take me? The part I love most is they need me more than they hate me, so they never. I remember seeing one of like New York in somebody's apartment back in Toronto, and I was like, you know what? When I have my own spot and a really cool spot, I want to have like a big ass Toronto poster. So. And then there was this company 3 hours away from Manila that custom printed it, cut it up, brought it here, installed it. That was like the missing thing, just because we have white, gray, black as a theme. To have this little color scheme going is ideal. Talking about things being affordable in the Philippines, because I'm so busy with my work on a daily basis, I like to cut out as many things as possible. So whether it's having somebody help me walk my dog, the meal plan so I don't have to think about my food. A big thing is I have a yaya that comes in 4 or 5 times a week. She's hired through Good Work, and she basically manages my life. Like, I mean, I don't have to think about making my bed when she's coming. I don't have to think about cleaning the apartment, making sure everything's organized. I spent a lot of time just like teaching her how to like put my clothes away, because I'm very specific with things. And at this stage, I mean, she's amazing. I trust her with everything. I trust her with my life. Like, I leave the apartment, I know she's not gonna touch anything she's not supposed to touch. I've left money out before. I left like $100. I was in a rush. She never took the money. Just, she's an angel. She's an angel. Like, I'm so happy that she's in my life. I'm so happy that she helps me manage my life and clean my apartment. And now for the piece de resistance. And I'm not much of a collector. What I have started collecting during lockdown is video games. I've always been a gamer. We got a VR system 3-4 months ago, and one of the best purchases I made during the lockdown. And we just have a ton of games, which I'm going to show you in a second.
Welcome to my garage, you know what I'm saying? Got a nice little collection here. Let's get it.
Alright, so you must be thinking, Rico, like, what's in your glass? Alright, I'm gonna break it down. This being the bachelor pad, we wanted to have a fully stocked bar. I actually have a vision for a different kind of bar where it would be bigger with a countertop and stuff. What's in my glass right now is Suntory Old. Japanese whiskeys are my favorite whiskey, and it's one of those, like, you don't have to add anything to it. Like, it's very smooth, it's not that expensive, so I just literally drink this on the rocks. And of course, we've got the Grey Goose, we've got sake, we've got Patron, Campari bitters with the vermouth is how you make a Negroni. And I've just been experimenting a lot during this lockdown with like cocktails and stuff like that. Sex on the beach, Negronis, martinis, polar bear martinis, just got the mint leaves for mojitos, and the Kraken, and a bunch of gin, so gin and tonics, and all the mixers here. We have another drawer with mixers, which I'll show you. I keep some of the mixers. The mixers there are just not for display, really. But like, I have like lemonade in here, ginger ale, Coke, Sprite, tonic water, soda water, everything you could possibly imagine. Not only do we have it there, we also have more over here. So we never run out of stock when it comes to booze and mixers. This is the kitchen area. I don't really do too much cooking, but it's a nice little kitchen. We have a borscht on the stove. Borscht and galupse, the Russian dishes. Good old washing machine situation, cleaning materials. And it wouldn't be a cribs if I didn't talk about what's in my fridge. I don't know, the fridge is jam-packed because we have the birthday party and the Halloween thing. So there's a cake over here. I don't usually have cake in the fridge, so don't think about that. I'm trying to live a healthy lifestyle. A bunch of booze as usual. Soju, there's wine for my Negronis. We got the vermouth. Always try to keep a little champagne in the fridge, you know what I mean? You never know when you might need that. But the main thing I wanted to focus on is this, like, sort of my healthy food lifestyle. So I have this meal plan that gets delivered to me 5-6 days a week. Paleo, this is a keto diet, So it's two meals a day. The calories already calculated. It's super healthy. It's called Nuthera, Nuthera.ph. Shout out to those guys. And in terms of like, I like my coffee with milk. So I started using almond milk, unsweetened, original. And of course, on a daily basis, I'm doing the green juice, the green and the red juice. Celery, no apples, because they usually have apples. I don't want too much sugar. Ginger, cucumber, moringa. And sometimes I ask them to put kale as a special request. I just keep eggs and bacon just randomly. Sometimes on the weekend, I want to have like a more American style breakfast. And then a bunch of cheeses. Got the cheddar, got the blue cheese, brie, Camembert, mozzarella, gouda, and of course Wolfgang's dog food for later. Mint leaves for the mojitos, lemon, oranges, mostly for cocktails. Like any fruits in my fridge, I'm probably using them for cocktails. Like I have like cherries in here and stuff like that. It's just for the drinks. So, speaking of healthy lifestyles, one of my favorite things about the Philippines is how affordable everything is. So I have my personal trainer come to my apartment and we work out in the living room area. Now that the gym is open, we also work out in the gym downstairs. So I've been doing combination of Muay Thai 2-3 times a week, eating the healthy foods, the diet plan, drinking green juice. So I feel fucking phenomenal. But one of the things that I think I struggled with in the past, and I think a lot of people struggle with, is snacks, right? So it's one thing if you have your diet or whatever, keto, paleo, whatever, and then you want to eat snacks at night and you end up eating potato chips or cookies or whatever. So what I started doing is I found a store called Real Foods and they deliver healthy snacks. So we have two cupboards. This is the healthy cupboard, which is my cupboard, and then this is the unhealthy one for all the people that like to come over to my place and eat my food and drink my booze. Let me show you what we have in the healthy book. Kale chips, rosemary, peppercorn, sour cream, and protein bars, tropical cashew cookies, you know what I mean? And then we have the nuts and so I mean, yeah, healthy. All right, so this is where the magic happens. Step into my office. This is my room, decent sized room. I wanted to make sure that I could maximize the space with having to work from home and stuff. I didn't want to have to be like in the living room when other people are doing stuff in the living room. So I did a lot of research on like Swedish architecture and just how modern European countries and architects kind of maximize space. So one of the first things I had custom made was that table to fit the room. So I measured the room, I measured exactly where I wanted to put it. And then the big thing as well is the bed. I had this bed custom, custom designed to, make sure that I still had space for the tables. Yeah, the tables themselves, I also had them custom. So I actually took two different designs and there's an awesome furniture shop. I think it's called CMS Furniture. I have them on my Instagram. I took two different designs. I gave them the exact measurements. They put it together. They drew it for me on the spot. And then they made the side tables in about 3 weeks. And it cost me about $100. So, I mean, it's kind of crazy how that works. So speaking of this area, this is my mini office space. I'm sure for any of you guys who follow me on YouTube, you've seen me record videos from this area. So this was cool because, I mean, it's a good size table. It's good for my laptop, fits with the chair, but there's also, you know, storage space for my documents. Really important, you know, just making sure that I keep all of my, making sure that I keep all of my documents organized and in the right place.
I want to be in my room, watch TV, and not be around people when they're making noise. So I had to get this, but it's like TV against the wall. It's kind of an awkward angle. So I had to get the omnidirectional joint and that custom put up so you can watch TV from here. I can actually watch TV from the fucking bathroom if I wanted to. Like, the door is open and that's my bathroom. another thing, just like the Toronto Skyline, the same guy has made this Batman poster, which is, again, is also custom, so I wanted it, I measured it, I wanted it to be like directly in the middle of the bed. And this is the Batman symbol from The Dark Knight. As I mentioned earlier, sort of the healthy lifestyle stuff, so like my yoga mats here, I was starting to build a home gym, but you know, obviously they opened up the gym in my building, so I actually don't really need these anymore, I just use the yoga mats. And let me show you what's in the closet. So we got the DSLR, you know, my little creams and lotions, gotta keep it smooth. And obviously my leather bag that I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen. With the Russian hat. And then step into my closet. I had to ship a lot of my stuff from China. I had to ship it over through DHL. I was on vacation in Jakarta and Bali when COVID hit, so I couldn't go back to China in January. So I had only the stuff that was in my suitcase. I got half of the things that are in my closet had to be shipped over, but yeah, obviously got the suits. I'm actually due for another suit soon. The custom shirts. Make sure it says Rico on there. You know, every single one of my shirts says Rico. And also with the suits as well. Details.
All right, that's my room, that's my space. I mean, what's to complain about? Like, I have beautiful furniture, an amazing view that I work from almost every day. And unfortunately, my roommate Nick left the country and can't come back because of COVID. But I'm gonna show you his room anyway, so follow me. So this is Nick's den. This is obviously the master bedroom, so it's got ensuite bathroom. And if you're wondering how we decided to split the rooms, when Nick lived with me in China, I had the master bedroom and he had the second room, which is a significantly smaller room than mine. So it was only fair that we kind of split it up this way. So like mine, he had his bed custom made as well. And then I imported this rug for him. So I basically like matched again the theme of the whole condo is white, gray, black. So we got the rug coming in from China. He bought this smart TV and there's a phenomenal view, similar view to the balcony of the Fort BGC and the BGC skyline. So it's a pretty dope room.
Ninja.
So here we have the infinity pool. This is a big part of the reason why we chose this condo was, you know, two bachelors in Manila, you know, that's always a good time in the Philippines in general. And we wanted to have this place be like a social, cool place. People can come hang out. So if you see behind over there, there's like this little bar area. So the idea was like, okay, we'll have drinks, we'll have food, and probably hire like a bartender or a caterer for some parties. And you have a little social sitting area. And then of course the actual pool, the actual infinity pool with a view of BGC. So this is the strip, you can see Shangri-La over there. My Muay Thai gym is just behind these buildings, so it's like perfect view of the city. Got the infinity pool for socializing, plenty of seating, and there's a little whirlpool as well in the corner. So there was always going to be like, we envisioned just a bunch of people having a good time, having drinks. My actual condo is just right up there, so we can also see the condo, we can see the view from there. And the gym, which at the time
was not open, it was under construction when we first moved in. But the gym is right there.
This is the little social area. Actually, I don't know if it's going to be open, but I want to show you another place. If I can find the light switch. So we have this area, which is like an event space. So if you want to rent it out, if you're having a party or whatever, like I mentioned before, sort of the pool party vibes. And if we go through this door, there's a game room, but it's closed right now because of COVID. The game room's cool as well. There's a pool table there. There's a TV, there's a, like, Monopoly, a bunch of board games. So when it does open up, it'll be nice. And last but not least, that's the gym, and then there's a little conference room here, business center. All right, so it's fucking hot as shit in here. And apparently, I don't know if this is World Health Organization rules or whatever, but we're not supposed to have an AC on in the gym. So the only thing we have is the exhaust fan. If you want to do hot yoga and shit like that, like, this is what it is. But I really like the design. This place was under construction and it was actually just shut down because of COVID. So we moved in March. The first time I got to use the gym was in September, and it's October now, so I've been able to use it for 2 months. But I do like the design. Like, this looks like a legitimate gym, and I like the, you know, the sort of dark rubber mats and exposed, like, concrete and things like that. Kind of reminds me of, like, the Batcave, you know. But yeah, I'm gonna get ready, like The Rock would say, do some clanging and banging in the Iron Paradise.
Dr. Corporate, approve memos, lead a workshop, remember birthdays, direct workflow, my own bathroom, micromanage, promote synergy.
Well, how does the old expression go? You don't have to go home, but you have to get the hell up out of here. Cheers.